Hey everyone, so we've magically transported ourselves over to the Zildjian booth now, and thanks to Ian, we've now been joined by Mr. Kaz Rodriguez. How you doing, Kaz?
Lovely to meet you. How you doing?
Very, very well.
Thanks, Ian, for having me, man.
All good. So, new introduction, Zildjian FX range.
Yeah.
Run us through it.
Right. So, we have the new line here for 2019, which is the FX stackers. They range from 8-inch all the way to 16. And it's a spectacular cymbal, so you can use them as an effects, a hi-hat, and you're going to use whatever you like through it. So what I would like to explain...
Oh, I've got a microphone now.
There we go.
There we go. So what I'd like to explain through here is knowing what you can do. There's three different things you can do with it. So if you look over here, they have a new bolt system called the Cymbals. And with this, you can change the tension at ease, but also being able to take it on and off from the hi-hat or from the cymbal stand. You can also use this as an X-hat, so you can turn it upside down and there's plenty of threading in order for you to use it as a standalone hi-hat.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
The material on the top is almost the same as using the low volume cymbals.
Yeah.
And the bottom you've got the steel, so it gives you the brightness, the sharpness and also projection. So, for example, this is probably high tension, or you could have it super loose just by unscrewing it a little, more open. Pretty cool.
Yeah, it seems really easy, and obviously being made out of material like they are, they're going to be relatively affordable as well.
Absolutely affordable, and that's the idea. What Zildjian are trying to do is to come up with something that is great for anyone to use, like if it's a kid that has some pocket money and is able to save up for a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
There you go.
Awesome.
So they range from 8 to 16.
Yeah.
So I'll just play a few of them from here. So like an 808 hi-hat.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Pretty good, right?
Yeah, I mean, as a range of sounds, I think there's something for everyone. Doesn't matter the application, someone's going to be able to find a sound that they can put into their sound.
Exactly, and it's just the fact that, you know, there's a lot of drummers that tend to see our setups and you see these really expensive stacks,
yeah,
but you get the exact same sort of level with these, and I mean, we've been using them all the time,
yeah,
and everybody's really blown away by not just the finish, but the fact that the effects catalog is now being enhanced.
Yeah.
So this is just one of many of those that's really great to check out.
I can see, I've been dying to get onto these. I have seen
right.
These new additions to the K range, and it's the Cluster Crash.
Yeah. So the Cluster Crash, I was first introduced to this about a couple of years ago.
Yep.
Paul and I were talking about why not hammer some cymbals in, and being able to see this, the idea behind the Cluster Crash is almost so you don't have to have holes in your cymbals to have an effect sound. So by putting the hammer, cluster hammers in, you're able to get more of a trashier and open sound,
yeah,
but also maintaining the fullness of the cymbal. So you can hear from here, they range from 18, 16, 20, and this is how they sound. They're really soft, they're very wafer thin. And the raw bell is what maintains the sound.
Yeah, I was going to say, they're very, very controlled. I was expecting to sound way more trashy than they are, but they almost, you know, they're very, very usable, so they're not like the effects crash or something like that.
No, and the idea is, because not many people like using holy cymbals,
yeah,
and the purpose of it is so you don't crack into it, because people are quite sensitive about,
yeah,
breaking into it, and when you do, it doesn't sound the same.
Yeah.
So with the complexity of just hammering, it really brings out those complex sounds, those trashy volumes.
Yeah. But it still maintains that bright cut at the top end as well.
Exactly. So this is the Cluster Crashes. Definitely check them out, because I think these ones are the hotcakes for this year, I reckon.
Awesome, man.
Yeah.
And then staying with the Kaz for now.
Yeah.
The Sweet Range at PMT, we've sold such a lot of it. It's been so well received in the market. 15 hats are some of the nicest hats that I've heard. New 14s, could really have 15s and not have a pair of 14s.
Exactly. So. Well, the idea was to make sure you have 15s and 16s because they almost replicate the light series hats,
yep,
where you have a lot of articulation, but you're able to have all these spectrums of dynamics.
Yep.
But put them on a 14, you still get the same articulation. Just bring it into a family, it makes sense.
Yep.
So, and these sound great. So. Really crisp, really sharp, and again, great for all styles of music, jazz, R&B, if you're rocking, and it doesn't overpower in your drums. So when you're playing a drum kit, you don't want anything that's overpowering sometimes. So this is pre-EQ'd. You don't even need to do much with it.
Awesome,
14-inch man. Three hats.
Then next.
My favorite.
I mean, I thought the 20 Crash of Doom was maybe overkill. According to Zildjian, bigger can be better.
And the thing about the Crash of Doom is celebrating the fact that when I used to watch Dennis Chambers play, and Dennis was like playing this cymbal that looked all warped and crazy, I was like, well, you know what, how about the Oriental in 22? And I actually, funny enough, I actually have a 24.
Wow, okay.
And that's even more buzzkill. But the options between this is so great because a lot of hip-hop guys are using things like crashes as rides and just one cymbal in general. So this has everything in general. It's still a thin cymbal. You can use it as a ride. This is how it sounds. Powerful.
It's a lot more control than I thought it was going to be though.
Because of the bell, a bit more larger as well, so it can sustain a bit more and can take a bit more from it as well. But the idea behind it is to be able to have many options within one cymbal, and it's a better way. 22 inches is always that area where you feel like it's too big, but it's great to use as a multiple source.
Yeah, cool.
And there you go, that's the Crash of Doom, it speaks for itself.
Awesome.
Yeah, no worries.